Good morning to all of you in class 11. And today we have our first class, that is accountancy. And today I am going to explain you the terminology of accountancy of class 11. So in terminology, I'll give you the basic terms which you will use in your course for commerce. So today I am going to explain you terminology, and in terminology I'll give you various terms which you will use, like capital. Capital means the invested amount by the proprietor to start the business. Initial investment is known as capital, as well as during the lifetime, if the businessman invests some additional capital, that is also termed capital. The capital may be brought in cash through bank in form of asset also. So capital means the invested amount by the proprietor to start the business. The next is assets. See, asset means all those things which are in the possession of the businessman, which are in the ownership of the proprietor. There are various types of assets, like land and building, plant and machinery, furniture and pictures, debtors, bank balance, cash balance. But from the accounting point of view, we classify the asset in two categories. One is current asset, another is non-current asset. Okay. For the another term for non-current asset is fixed asset. So today I will explain you these two terms, then further we will move on. Okay, now see, first please note down also, first term, that is capital. Capital refers to amount of money, goods and assets invested by the proprietor in a business enterprise. Capital is also known as owner's equity or net worth or net assets or internal liabilities. It is also excess of asset over outside liabilities. So my dear children, today I am going to explain you this term. So one formula is also there in accountancy, that is accounting equation. So from the point of view of accounting equation, we have one equation in commerce, that is TA is equals to TA is equals to capital plus liabilities. A is equals to L plus C. See, in the example also, it is clearly given, Mr. Ram has decided to start a business with cash 5 lakh, machinery 2 lakh, goods 3 lakh. It means the total capital invested in the business is 10 lakh rupees. Okay, my dear children, I'm sure you must understood. Capital means the amount invested by the proprietor in a business enterprise to start the business, to set up the business, to operate the business. But be clear, that should be, that may be in form of money, in form of goods, in form of assets. Like Mr. Ram has decided to start a business. Cash 5 lakh, machinery 2 lakh, goods 3 lakh. It means the total initial investment is 10 lakh rupees. Okay, so here 10 lakh rupees will be his capital. So capital is also known as owner's equity. It means the amount invested by owner. Net worth. Net worth means the total value of the business, net asset or internal liability. Why internal liability? Capital is known as internal liability because it is invested by the businessman, by the proprietor. Okay, my dear children? And C, it is also the excess of assets over outside liability. Just now I gave you one accounting equation. That equation is asset is equals to liabilities plus capital. Liabilities plus capital. See here, liabilities means outside liabilities and capital means inside liabilities. Okay, internal liability. Liability term, outsider's liability, and capital is used for internal liability. So in the given example, 5 lakh cash, 2 lakh machinery, 3 lakh goods, it means the total amount invested by the businessman is 10. Very good. Next term is drawings, just opposite of the capital. See, capital means amount invested and drawings means amount withdrawal from the business. Many times, a businessman also requires to pay some amount for household expenditures, for personal expenses. These expenses, which are withdrawn by the business, are termed as drawings. But my dear children, drawings may be in cash or in goods, both. So here it is the amount of money or the value of goods or services which is withdrawn by the proprietor of a business for his domestic or personal use. Domestic, personal, household expenditure. Okay. So any private payment made out of business money is also known as drawings. Example. See the example of drawings. Mr. Ram has withdrawn rupees 10,000 per month out of his business money. It means the total drawings during the year 1,20,000. It is the amount of money or the value of goods or asset which is withdrawn by the proprietor of a business for his domestic or personal use. Any private payment made out of business money are also known as drawings. See example, Mr. Ram has withdrawn 10,000 rupees per month out of business money. It means his total drawings during the year was 1,20,000. LIC premium paid, income tax paid, salary paid to domestic servant, rent paid for proprietor's resident out of his business funds are drawings. Okay, my dear children, I'm sure you all must understood what I am teaching to you. Okay, see, drawings may be in cash or in kind. In cash or in kind? Yes. A businessman can withdraw the amount in cash as well as drawings of goods also possible. The businessman, I am giving you example. Businessman is doing the business of saris. So if the proprietor's wife comes to the shop and take two saris, the businessman cannot take money from her. That will be termed as goods withdrawal. Okay, these two sarees will be entered in the books as goods withdrawal, or that will be termed as drawings. Now we will move towards next term, that is today's our new term is asset. Now, asset in the business, see, assets are valuable resources owned by business enterprises which can be measured in terms of money. Means only those things which the business can measure in terms of money will be known as assets. Anything which will enable a business enterprises to get cash or benefit in future is an asset. Example, see the examples, land and building, plant and machinery, furnitures and fittings, closing stocks, cash, bank, okay? Now the features of asset. Yes, children, I will explain you. Wait. Assets are valuable resources owned by a business enterprises which can be measured in terms of money. Anything which will enable a business enterprise to get cash or a benefit in future is in asset. Like vehicle. Vehicle or car here, that is my asset. How you can say this is my asset, my dear children? Because we can express it in terms of money. We can value, we can show it, we can exchange it. That is in terms of money. And this will enable a business enterprises to get the benefit. Okay. So, my dear children, land and building, plant and machinery, furniture and fixtures, stock, cash balance, bank balance, computer, laptop, fans, AC, car, all are the asset of the businessman. Now, what are the features of asset? Major feature. Assets owned by the business. Ownership is in the hands of the proprietor. Then second, it has some value. Okay, and it acquired at a measurable money cost. Yes, my dear. Assets can be expressed in terms of money. Now see the types of assets. Classification of asset. Basically, assets are of two types. Current assets. See other names. Floating asset, circulating asset, active asset, short-lived asset. Current assets are those assets which can be converted into cash within 12 months, within 1 year, and which are meant for resale purpose, reuse purpose, resale. And these assets can be converted into cash within 1 year, within 12 months, like a stock. A businessman makes the goods for resale purpose and that stock will be converted into cash within 1 year, within 12 months. So that is termed as current asset. Few examples of current assets are these: cash balance, bank balance, bills receivable, closing stock, debtors, prepaid expenses, accrued income. Yes. Further, I will explain you the meanings of debtors, prepaid expenses in other terminology. Now, next is non-current asset. Non-current assets are known as fixed assets. But be clear, fixed asset doesn't mean that it is fixed at one place, that like this table. No, fixed asset means those assets which we have for long time period for the purpose of production of goods, for providing services, not meant for resale purpose. These assets increase the earning capacity of the business. Like plant, machinery, furniture, equipments, these are fixed assets. Yes, vehicle also fixed asset. Be careful. Vehicle, plant and machinery, furniture and fixtures, these electronical equipments, all are fixed asset. Now, fixed asset also classified into categories. Tangible asset and intangible asset. Now, tangible assets. See, my dear children, tangible assets are those assets which can be seen, which can be touched. These assets have physical existence, like land and building, plant and machinery, furniture and fittings, vehicles, laptop, smart class, all are tangible assets. Okay, we can give more example of tangible asset. Your phone, your laptop, AC in your room, okay, fridge at your home, all are tangible asset. How we can say tangible asset? Because these assets we can see, we can touch. Okay, now next is intangible assets. This is new term for you now. Intangible assets are those assets which cannot be seen and touched. They do not have any physical existence, like land and building, plant and machinery. We cannot see, we cannot touch. These assets are intangible assets, like goodwill, trademark, patent, copyright. Further, I will give you these terminology also. So children, today, just now, I explain you three terms. See on the board, mainly assets are classified in two categories, current asset, non-current asset. Non-current asset also known as fixed asset. Fixed asset classified in broadly in two categories, that is tangible asset and intangible asset. Okay, then some new term for you, vesting assets, which are consumed through being worked or used. It includes those assets which get exhausted with lapse of time, like oil wells, coal mine, etc. Then last is fictitious assets, nominal assets. Fictitious assets are those assets which do not have any physical existence. They are expected not to realize. Further, I'll explain you about these terms also. Okay, now children, I'm sure you all must understood what I taught you just now. Three terminology. First is capital. Capital means amount invested. Okay, now second is assets. Assets means the total value of ownership of that person. That may be current asset, fixed asset. Then fixed assets also classify tangible asset, intangible asset. Fixed assets are also known as non-current asset. Okay, children? Any doubt?